What are you doing? Descattys. Get the day. I'm getting out more than fucking Alan Wicker at the moment. I'm just out with the dog. We're going for just a bimble really. Enjoying it. It's quite dry at the moment, but it's very humid. Very sort of like very close right now. But obviously everything's in full swing. Nature's really enjoying itself and having fun and everything else, and I am too. So I'm just going for a nice bimble. I'm gonna go and find a little woodland spot and do a few bits in there, and just enjoy the day. Oh, what's that? Let's have a look at the old, there's a bee there, look, on a bit of teasel lounging about. Oi, oi, son, look, collecting the old pollen. That's it, mate. Lovely jubbly. Yeah, look at that. Fucking hell. Look at that wildlife footage, eh? Oh, there's another one now. On a bit of vetch. Nah. All right, Rose, get away. Yeah, just because you ain't in the camera. Yeah, so there he is, folks. Well, I'll see you in a little while. And, I'll just do my usual Steven Spielberg prowess and just video and take pictures. There's obviously a lot of plantage and that around at the moment, as there is. And what I'll do is I'll probably chuck in a few little bits of, like little tips and ideas and stuff like that that you can use for yourself when you're out in nature. So anyway, it's probably all the fucking shit you already know, but anyway, it's coming from me anyway. So catch up in a little while, folks. All the best. I literally have just had a wonderful conversation with another dog walker, and I see the geezer as he was coming around on the bend, and he's got two Border Terriers, and it's just nice. It's not, I mean, you know, if people know what terriers are like, I'm not going to keep going on about it, but you know, sometimes they can be a little, they require some patience from both the dog owner as well as the dog itself, but the dog is who the dog is. And it was lovely, we were just chatting. Must have been speaking for about half hour, 40 minutes I reckon. and we were just chatting about dogs, chatting about the Countryman's Weekly, all country pursuits. I mean, he was a hell of a lot older than me, but he was saying about he had the real early Countryman's magazines and Shooting Weekly and Sport, you know, all the shooting sports and all the real early magazines and stuff. And it was just really nice, so I just thought I'd share that with you. Should have got him in the video, really. I don't know if he'd appreciated it, but yeah, it's sort of nice talking to people like that, especially people that have that are terrier owners. Right, so yeah, anyway, I'll carry on. is. I'm going to collect some nettles for, I've got some noodles, so I'm going to have some noodles and nettles to sort of stoke up my lunch. I'm trying to find some nice specimens. Nice little bundle there for my noodles. Hey. Off, folks. Here's my nettles and noodles. Lovely chubbly. All nice and cooked. Nicely simmered. And there we go. Give a little extra bit of iron, I suppose, to have the flavouring of the noodles. They are nice. Normally I blanch them over the fire. lance the leaves. So that just kills the trichomes. The trichomes are just like the hairs that are on the needles. But this time round, I'll just, as you see there previously, I'll just pull them off the leaf, off the stem, sorry, and put the leaf straight in there and then boil them. And that's how it's come out. So lovely jubbly. as you can see there, I've just made a twisted sort of cobra stitch, not dissimilar to the one that I've got on the Nomad. A nice tub of goodness, I suppose. I normally take these when I go to work as well, and it's basically in their goji berries. I've got some wasabi peas, macadamia nuts, walnuts, and then I mix it up with a bit of chocolate as well, chocolate buttons and stuff, just to give me a little bit of a chocolate energy, I suppose. And walnuts as well, which I eat these every day pretty much. And quite handy for when I'm out and about, I suppose, and also at work. Normally what I do is give them a shake up and then just put a mouthful in my mouth and chew them on the go. Pretty good really, nice wholesome foods I suppose, apart from the chocolate. Even the dog likes them. She's not going to have the chocolate though, I'll give her a yoghurt one. Indeed.
Go again. Go at it. Go get it. Go get it. Go get it. Hey.
Rosie does not like a lot of fruit. I can count on one finger the amount of fruit she likes. Give her a blackberry though. And she loves them. The inner part of the Camerina gustafolium, the fireweed, this pit in the middle, it's actually edible. It's actually quite refreshing. Pick off the outer skin, and what you're left with is this bit in the middle. Actually quite refreshing. Fucking hell, it looks like something out of Deliverance, doesn't it? Expect a load of fucking rednecks to come out of there in a minute. Expect me to get my pants off. Breaking out the gin soon. The old slow berries starting to show their lovely head. Once they turn purple. I hope you enjoy that little video. Nice to get out for some time over the woods. Enjoy a brew, some noodles, nettles, and all the bits that I've put on the about the plants, the foraging, the stuff that I've showed you. Although I read books on the stuff, kind of the information that I've put down on each photograph. It's basically my own personal experience, what I've had with those particular plants. Okay, right, so it's from my own experience, so it's tried and tested 100%. All right, So there it is, folks. All right, so thank you for watching as usual. All right, please leave your comments, hit the old thumbs up button if you want to, but don't forget to subscribe to my channel, which would be nice. Nice to see some even more people, YouTube viewers and spectators. All right, so thanks for watching, folks. Take care. Descattys, see you on the flip side. Laters. Say goodbye, Rosie. Well, say goodbye then.
Oh, bloody hell.
Can't get the staff these days. See you later, folks. Take care.